Marshall, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Who is this?
My name is Jesse Faden. I'm coming to help.
Faden? Hold on. I'm setting the elevator for you. We need to talk.
You got that right.
More of you? Really?
French said his team knows all the Bureau's secrets, Marshall especially. Does she know what happened to Dylan?
Welcome to the party, ma'am. Marshall is right down the hall. Marshall's eager to speak with you now.
There you are. I was starting to worry. Congratulations on your appointment, Director Phaeton. I'm Helen Marshall, head of Bureau Operations. Zachariah's dead then, and I assume you found his gun.
Just call me Jesse. Trench told me to find you. He said you could help.
And he told you this through the hotline. Makes sense.
None of this fazes her? Really?
Here's the situation. Darling created the HRAs in a lab nearby. We need more if we're gonna survive this attack. My Rangers can't secure the lab alone, not against those things. We need more firepower.
At least she seems to know what's going on here. She could know about Dylan.
I can clear out the hiss. I'll be your firepower.
That's a good answer.
Is she testing me?
Darling has systems in place to protect his labs. This should help you get past them. We'll talk more after you clear out the hiss. Rangers, let her through. We'll have to lock the door behind you. Sorry, but we can't risk a breach.
Thank you. Altered item number 52AE analysis, session 2. I will begin by introducing various stimuli to the item. First, a low voltage electric shock. No response. Next, I will introduce heat via a standard Bunsen burner. No response. Next, a series of solutions will be applied, each with a different value on the pH scale, from 0 to 14. No response to any value. Next, I will attempt to communicate. Can you understand me? Can you understand my words? Quack, if you can understand my words. No response. This concludes session 2. We'll need time to prepare further tests.
This way to the lab? Okay. You must like these HRAs.
Sounds like Darling built them. And most of the things around here. If Marshall can't help us with Dylan, he's our next best bet. Assuming he's not dead. Or taken over by the Hiss.
Thank you.
You led me here. Any idea how to make it work?
Hello again, Director. It appears we have a new problem. We need to get the HRA machine working.
I've replaced a couple of spark plugs, but this looks a bit more complicated.
Darling must have had a system. Randomness isn't in his nature. The punch cards, the symbols, the terminals. How do they connect?
I'll see what I can do.
So, we need to find all the punch cards. Each punch card should correspond to a terminal. These whiteboard drawings may be important. Looks like he was working on something to do with these symbols.
Thank you.
prism shattered. Darling's prototypes have a lot of issues. We need a new plan. We need more Blackrock prisms to make this machine work. Darling has another lab, down in the Blackrock processing site and maintenance. That must be where he keeps the prisms.
I've been to maintenance already. I can find my way.
But how long will that take? Nothing here is simple. I need to ask her now, before I go.
I need something from you first. What do you know about Dylan Faden?
I knew this was coming. Lives are at stake here, and we need this machine working to save those lives. Once that is done, Director Faden, then we can talk.
She's right. As much as I don't want to admit it, I'm the only one who can help.
Fine. I'll get the prisms first.
Dylan will have to wait just a little longer.
But don't call me Director. Jesse is fine.
I'll call you Faden. Here, you'll need this keycard.
Thanks. Emily Pope has set up a base in Executive. Once I have the prism, I'll meet you there.
Right. I'll move out immediately. And keep an eye out for Darling. Finding him might be the key to stopping the hiss.
It's just one large-scale HRA. It's there now. We are about to be exposed to a different kind of resonance. Hostile, viral, invasive resonance. That's what the Hedron resonance amplifiers are for. Taking the protection Hedron can provide us and keeping us from being wiped out.
Here, this will lead back to Central Research.
altered item number 52.
Resonance is the key. Vibration, frequencies, waveforms, fields we didn't know were there. It's physics. These fields in complex interaction, altering reality that comes to contact with them. Hedren is communicating with me. He's trying to warn me of something imminent. I've been using every known method to analyze the data. Exposing myself to it. I'm seeing things and overcome by compulsion. It's not just data, it's protection. It's benign. We are about to be exposed to a different kind of resonance. Hostile, viral, invasive resonance. That's what the Hedren resonance amplifiers are for. Taking the protection Hedren can provide us and keeping us from being wiped out.
Thank you. I'm averse to using objects of power. I don't want to lean on things I ultimately can't trust. But the ashtray and the cigarette, smoking there forever, have their uses. The ashtray maze they conjure is an impossibly changing labyrinth that no one but the Binder, and those the Binder invites, can ever pass through. The things we hid in dimensional research, the things Darling studies, the danger and the risk involved, call for every measure of security and protection I could bring to the table. The maze, hands down, is our strongest lock. I gave Darling and his chosen crew license to pass through the maze. Lately, I've started to think I should revoke that license.
Thank you. Welcome back.
Hope wants us to compile all of Darling's data entries from the past month.
She wants us to crack Darling's personal log. Crucify his
alterations in his corrupted organism vary so wildly. What's the connection?
Hi, Jesse. See you soon.
Be careful out there.
Hope wants us to compile all of Darling's data entries from the past month.
She wants us to crack... Darling's personal log? If he finds out, who does she think she is authorizing that kind of data breach?
She must think he's hiding something, and I agree. HRAs alone are proof Darling knew more than he let up. On.
Marshall knows something about Dylan. Is he here? Is he all right? HRAs first. They'll help save everyone, including Dylan, once I find him. Can you keep him safe? Like you do with me?
Thank you.
It's ridiculous. Pope's grasping the
surface. Why? If this is a frequency, then why couldn't it vibrate molecules in order to alter physiology? It would explain the neurons.
Think about it. We're still trying to acquire is unthinkable.
This is Lynn Salvador, head of Bureau Security. I'm making a formal security order due to the incident in April, case number 21HQ593. Improper use of the jukebox altered item led to two fatalities. We believe a pair of agents used the jukebox to travel to the quarry threshold and engage in inappropriate workplace behavior. An expedition team found them decomposing at the formation's base a week later. At least we found out the jukebox doesn't bring corpses back when the song ends. I'm having the jukebox placed in a secure location in the executive sector. It should never have been accessible to low clearance staff in the first place. The new location security and proximity to a high traffic area will prevent misuse while still allowing for expedition teams to access it when required. See me for any further details.
Looking good on hardware. Needs
to read on all this.
It's bad, but we can handle it. Just like we handled that altered item making everyone drown themselves in the tanks.
Trench contained that thing. He's gone.
I can't believe these suits lasted as long as they have.
He's off.
Bullshit.
That is his comms.
You are
what grows on seven relevant through the air.
I wonder if other species would verbalize the hiss resonance like human hosts do.
Yep.
Has followed you in, right?
Every time I think it makes sense. Pattern ship.
Thank you.
warranty. I wouldn't go in there without talking to Underhill first. Even if you have, I still wouldn't go in.
Excuse me? Are you lost? Do you normally barge into people's private workspaces?
She clearly doesn't know who she's talking to.
Shouldn't you be in a safe room?
Why? Because of those hiss things the Rangers keep going on about. Haven't you people sorted that out yet? The situation down here could spell doom for the Bureau.
You mean this mold?
Correct. Perhaps you could help me. I require samples of various mold strains, and the mold has made the environment far too dangerous for me to fetch them myself.
Really? Mold samples? I thought this could spell doom.
It could, and it will, whoever you are. The mold is spreading. We need to find the source before it spreads too far.
And these samples will do that?
No. Samples of 5 unique strains, when blended properly, will allow you to travel deeper into the pit where I've pinpointed the approximate location of the source of the mold.
Okay. So what do these samples look like?
Similar to the one on my table there. I've made a list of the samples I need, here. You'll find them throughout the threshold.
I'll take a look. My name's Jesse, by the way.
I'm sure it is.
Have you worked at the FBC very long?
Not long enough to understand their inane methodology. They want me to solve the mold, but how is one to solve anything when the basic molecular structure of this fungus is an utter enigma?
Oh, sorry, are you asking me?
It's rhetorical. The Bureau wants to control, not comprehend. But to answer your question, I'm a seasoned threshold researcher that's been brought in on a provisional basis to resolve this matter.
That's all you had to say.
What have you learned about the mold?
Firstly, the term mold is a gross oversimplification used only to ease communication. That said, the mold itself appears to be the product of complex microorganisms. They spin the mold, building structures like minuscule cities, swiftly colonizing our dimension. And the speed of these tiny engineers relative to their size is simply staggering.
So it grows fast.
If you're not going to listen, then why did you ask?
So the mold is coming in from... where?
We don't have a name for the threshold dimension. The origin point has been identified, but the density of the fungus makes it impossible to enter. Even if we could, I speculate that we would only find a reality entirely subsumed by the fungus. Total decomposition!
It's weird how excited she is, right?
What do you know about the hiss?
How could I know anything about an entity I've only just learned of? This is exactly the Bureau's problem. My work is always interrupted by these superfluous matters.
Calm down. Just keep your HRA on and I'm sure you'll be fine.
This crude thing. I thought it was Darling's idea of a practical joke.
Not quite. Just keep your head down while I handle the hiss. I need to get going.
Try not to transport any spores outside the infected areas.
This is Lynn Salvador, head of Bureau Security. I'm making a formal security order due to the incident in April.
No need to hurry back.
weed down here. Suddenly I'm really hungry. I wonder how this mold tastes. Are those people? Gross. Underhill is gonna owe me for this. One of Underhill's samples.
building shifts occur at random and without warning. But with the Bureau's cutting-edge technology, we can stabilize the oldest house. Safe employees are happy employees. Certain rituals allow agents to navigate the oldest house as well. But accidents do happen. Trapping agents inside the walls. I heard you got stuck in your room for 3 days, Topher. Too bad you didn't have your book with you.
Or any food.
And remember, kids, when you feel the floor deviate, it's already much too late.
Found one. This must be one of the samples.
Thank you.
This looks like a good one. That's all five samples. I should get these back to Underhill.
You look like a woman with mold for me. This work won't finish itself. Perhaps it might.
I found all five. But I kind of wanted to eat them.
The mold has that effect on some people. Likely due to the fact it's not actually mold, or even of this dimension. I suspect it is the result of two incompatible molecular structures, one dominant, coming into contact. I call it mold, or fungus, because it's closer in appearance and behavior than anything else we know. Except perhaps bacteria.
She reminds me of my old biology teacher.
Did you happen to meet any more members of my ranger detail?
I didn't see any rangers. Just walking mold people. Unless...
Yes. If you found mold people, you found my rangers. I refer to the creatures as hosts. They, like other unwary agents, succumbed to the appetite. But that's nothing for you to worry about. The pill I'm about to make with these samples will make the lower level perfectly safe to traverse. It has the added benefit of immunizing you against the pit's toxic spores. Now leave me to it.
I need to get going.
Try not to transport any spores outside the infected area.
I hate guard duty down here.
This place is fucking weird.
This is nothing. Clocks?
Something.
I need to get going.
Try not to transport any spores outside.
Be careful down there. We don't want to have to come save you.
mind me.
My time is something I value. With that in mind, what do you need?
I need to get going.
Try not to transport any spores outside the infected areas.
Be careful down there. We don't want to have to come save you.
Marshall knows something about Dylan. Is he here? Is he all right? HRA's first. They'll help save everyone, including Dylan, once I find him. Can you keep him safe? Like you do with me?
blows.
Director Faden,